Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk about my power word for the year. It's been about 3.5 months into the new year and my word for this year is better. I want to be better in every single area of my life possible. It comes to fitness, when it comes to my health, when it comes to my work ethic, when it comes to my relationships, my friendships, my passions, like my pursuit of those things, all of it I just want to be better at. But why I chose that word was not what it means to me now. What it means to me now is just constantly trying to improve by 1% every single day, just trying to be better in all areas all the time. But at the time that I chose that to be my word, I was in a place of like despair. I don't know if that's too dramatic of a word, but I was feeling very hopeless, very sad, very depressed, and all I wanted was to feel better. I just wanted to feel a little happiness. I just wanted to feel a little hope, and I just wanted to feel better than I did at that time, that first couple days of the new year, because I didn't prepare for this new year like I normally do. And the reason why I didn't is because I was in a very dark place towards the end of last year, where actually for most of last year, and I wasn't really focused on the future. I was goal setting and I was making vision boards and I was very like excited about like the long-term future, but I didn't have like the short-term vision. You know, I have a ton of long-term vision and I have an idea of exactly how I want to live and who I want to be and, you know, what kind of wife I want to be, what kind of mom I want to be, what kind of businesswoman I want to be, and all of these great ideas. But I didn't have very much short-term vision to do the necessary things to get me there, and then I would feel like what I'm doing isn't enough, or like I'm never gonna reach these things and whatever. So in the beginning of this year, I felt a little upside down in my world. I felt very uncertain in a lot of ways, and all I wanted to do was just feel better. Not even be better yet, just feel better. So there was a couple of different ways that I started doing that. I started journaling a lot and writing out my feelings and things like that. And at that time I was operating from a place of lack. I kind of felt like I wasn't enough. I felt like I wasn't doing enough. I felt like I wasn't enough of anything. And that's why I needed to be better, because who I was wasn't enough. And in the last 3.5 months, I've shifted that mindset from, you know, feeling like I'm not enough today and just being better and better and better every single day, but actually acknowledging that I am doing the best that I can. And the best that I can today doesn't have to be the best that I can tomorrow. You know, sometimes that's going to differ. It's not always going to be, you're not always going to be 100% every single day. And that's okay. That doesn't mean you're not enough. That doesn't mean that you are lacking anything. It's just you have to do the best you can in regards to like your capacity for that day. Some days are bad, some days are good. And you have to take control of those and see them as like, okay, well, this was just a bad moment, or this was just a bad day, or whatever, and not let it continue on in like a streak. So it's been really pivotal for me to stop operating from a place of lack and seeing myself as not enough and just like needing to work on myself, needing to work, needing to grow, needing to develop, needing to be all of these things that I'm not, or that I thought that I wasn't, and shifting that to I'm so grateful for who I am today. I'm so grateful for all of the experiences, all of the lessons, all of the flaws that I possess, all of the mistakes that I've made, all of the, I'm even grateful for the things that I do lack, because that means that I still have so much more room to grow, and I can do it in a place from, I can do it from a place of hunger and desire, and be very humble about it. And I heard something, I read something today that said happiness is, the state that you experience in between, you know, achieving one desire and another desire coming, because happiness comes from a lack of desire. So when you're not wanting for anything, you're happy. And I felt like I was wanting for so much, so I never felt happy. I never allowed myself to experience happiness or bliss in this moment because I was constantly focused on just being better and almost putting myself down to say like, oh, you're like, you're not doing enough, or, you know, you're not strict enough on yourself, or, you know, whatever the case may be in that area of my life. So I have now viewed being better and be better as an opportunity for small incremental changes that can add up and build incredible results for you. It really is about the little things that you do every single day that compound and make big impacts. You know, you don't have to all of a sudden be, you know, this like fitness guru or this, you know, self-development guru or anything like that. You don't have to, you know, have overnight success or anything like that. Like, it really is about the work that you put in and the dedication you have to sharpening yourself and creating good habits and creating good routines and doing the work behind it all that is going to compound, and then your results come. And I've always had an issue with comparing myself to other people, and not necessarily who they are, because I'm very, very happy with who I am. I like myself. I love myself. And I've worked really hard to get to that point where I am confident in who I am, and I appreciate my core values. I appreciate, you know, my character, and I genuinely have love for who I am and who I know I'm created to be. However, I do get in this place sometimes where I'm like, oh, like, I just want to be there already. I just want to be doing what I love to do, making the money that I would love to make with the people that I love, in the places that I want to be. And I just have this like burning passion to have all of these things, and so it can make me a little impatient and then cause me to like compare, well, how is she doing this and how is he doing this, and it's not even about the how, it's more like, why am I not there yet? And it can be borderline counterproductive, because then you start to instill doubt in like who you are and your place and your process and your progress and your journey. And I want to make it a priority to not see being better as me not being enough today, because I am more than enough for exactly where I am today in my life. But because I don't want to remain here, I understand that I need to grow, and I understand that I need to sharpen myself. I understand that I need to, you know, invest in myself. And it's okay. That doesn't mean that I'm not enough. That doesn't mean I'm not a good person. That doesn't mean that I can't make an impact. That doesn't mean that I'm not able to speak up and start doing the things that I love now, because I'm completely capable. I have everything I possess necessary in order to make small changes and small impacts now, and that doesn't take away from the future that I plan to have. So that has been a really recent revelation, because I have experienced what I feel excuse me, what I feel is exponential growth in my inner world in the last couple of months. And what I mean by my inner world is, I mean like literally I have done so much work in my soul, in my heart, and my mindset, and I just feel like an incredibly different person. Although if you look at my life from, you know, the outer world in regards to what I do for a living, what I'm driving, you know, where I can travel to, my financial statistics, and my relationships. Like, I don't have everything that I want in the real world or in the material world, is what I'm trying to say. So my outer world hasn't changed much yet, but that's the big thing. That's the important thing, is it hasn't changed yet. But I've done all the work, not all the work necessary to get everything that I want, because it's a constant work in progress. Being better, sharpening your skill set, growing, developing, that is just a never-ending journey. And I will always remain a student of life. I will always remain, you know, somebody who's in love with developing herself, because all of the things that I want and the person that I want to be is so much more important to me than the things that I want to have. You know what I mean? Not that I don't want to have nice things, because I do, but who I'm becoming in that process is far more valuable than what the outer world is going to shift into. So choosing to not operate from a place of lack, you know, it's really easy to get caught up in like, oh, I feel like I'm growing so much and I feel like I'm constantly focused. I make these vision boards, I do my affirmations, I manifest things, I, you know, have all of these ideas and I talk to people about them and I start doing the research, I start doing the work and I'm, you know, I've done this much, I've studied for this, I've taken this test, I've done this and I've done that. Why isn't my life changing yet? But your inner world is always going to transform before your outer world does. Your heart, your soul, your mind, you have to grow into the person who's going to be able to handle the life that you want to live and the life that you want to lead and the person you want to be. You know, he or she has to have, you know, another level of capacity to navigate, you know, the waters that you want to travel. So, I'm very excited about that because I feel like I have experienced tremendous transformation in my inner world and exponential growth in my inner world and who I am every day when I wake up, the thoughts that I have, just thinking about the thoughts that I have about myself and about my life and about my future, they are 1,000 times better than they were 5 months ago. And although I'm not, you know, a stranger to a negative thought here and there, and although I'm not a stranger to, you know, feeling sad or feeling lonely sometimes or getting scared and having a sense of fear or maybe even a small moment of doubt, but they're significantly less, exponentially less than they were all of last year. And that makes me really happy and really excited and really forward thinking because I know that change is coming. I know that big opportunities are coming to me and I could feel it. You know, I know that my life is going to change dramatically in the next year because I'm dedicated to that. I've dedicated myself to grow into the person who is going to be worthy of these opportunities to come to me and be valuable enough to actually contribute to the people and the places and the opportunities that are going to come to me. I need to have something to offer. And I've really, really worked on that part of it. So I know that those things are going to happen and I'm going to put myself in those places and actually know where to go and what to do when that time arises. So yeah, I just wanted to share that because I feel like a lot of times, you know, there's all this like personal development out there and there's all of this motivation and sometimes it can be a lot to take in and it can make you feel really negatively about yourself because you're like, man, I've just been talking so negatively about myself all of these years and that's why I'm stuck. And then you get into this negative cycle again and you're like thinking that you're not enough and you have this place of lack and you feel like, well, if I was already the person that I'm supposed to be to have everything I want, I would already be there and I would already be doing it and all these things that we hear on the daily. But it's okay. You're exactly where you're supposed to be. You're listening to this, you're listening to the development that you hear, you're listening to those messages for a reason, and it's not going to go to waste. If you listen to what you're hearing and you actually choose to apply it, you don't have to feel like you're not enough because you're exactly where you needed to be. You heard exactly what you needed to hear from who you needed to hear it from. And now is your chance to take that and say, okay, well, I'm not 100% satisfied or happy with where I am today, but I'm grateful. I'm grateful that I got to this point of dissatisfaction because now I have that hunger reignited in me to move forward faster than I would have before. If I would have just been content, if I would have just been comfortable, then maybe these words of, you know, motivation, or maybe this, you know, little thought that came into my head, maybe that little negative thought, or maybe that little like self-reflection moment wouldn't have come if you were already so content and so comfortable. So it's okay to be a little uncomfortable. It's okay to feel a little bit like, oh, like frustrated with yourself, but it doesn't have to be from a place of lack. It can come from a place of abundance and just wanting so much more for yourself. But understand that you have to be grateful for where you are. Opportunity, blessings, you know, God isn't gonna bless somebody or bring things to people who can't already be grateful for what they have and who they are. You have to express gratitude in order to attract abundance and bring abundance into your life. You have to, you know, you have to put it out there that you're grateful and you cherish those things. Because let me tell you, when you don't cherish things and you don't cherish people and you don't cherish experiences and you don't cherish even mistakes and lessons, you have to be grateful for those things. Otherwise, they will be gone before you know it. So all I'm saying is there's a fine line between being better and not being enough, and how you process that and how you feel it. You are enough. You have enough. You can do enough. You have so much capability, so much capacity in who you are today. And although it's not enough to get where you want to be eventually, just be grateful for who you are, because you have enough knowledge to know that you need to grow, and you have enough knowledge to realize that you are feeling unhappy or you are feeling dissatisfied, and you can take the steps necessary to grow into the person who is going to build that life that you want to live. But you sitting around and complaining, or you know, having these negative thoughts about yourself, or feeling, you know, like the comparison game, all of that stuff is not going to lead to productivity. It's okay to acknowledge it, to realize it, to have that moment, to have the realization, to be self-aware is okay. But you also have to be self-appreciative, because no one else is going to appreciate you in your life if you don't first, and they're not going to be there to support your growth and your decisions if you can't appreciate who you are and all you do is complain about yourself. So that, I don't know if that was like my original intention for this video, but that just all kind of came out of me. So I hope that, I feel really excited because I'm about to go into the gym and I feel like I'm gonna have a really good workout now. But I hope that something that I said resonated with you, and just know that if you are watching this and you got through all 17 minutes of this video, it was for a reason, and now you just have to take whatever little butterfly happened in you and go do something about it. So yeah, till next time. I have nothing else to say.